Hello po mga kaibigan, mga kapuso, kapatid at kapamilya. Welcome once again dito na muli sa aming podcast, Nerding With You. My name is Tops and this is...
Glenn, yes. Your clueless wife, Glenn.
Yes, so obviously, nasa iba na naman kaming lugar ngayon. So hope you. Today is going to be a very special episode because we are going to be having over a very...
special guest.
Parang sabi ko na yata yung special guest. He's a preacher, but also, most importantly, he is our nerdy preacher. Siya po ay feast builder ng Feast Makati.
Yes, all the way.
All the way from the Philippines. Yes, so inilipad pa po namin siya papunta dito sa UK. And syempre, magzoom naman kami. Mastipid. So, huwag na po natin patagalin pa. Let's all welcome the Almighty Toh Relova. And here it is, ang ating guest all the way from the Philippines. Makati po, di ba? Makati, tama?
Makati.
Yes, welcome yes. Brother Toh Relova. Palakpakan.
Yay,
our the reason why we invited Brother Toh Relova is because sa lahat po kasi ng mga fina-follow ko ng mga preachers, feast preachers or feast builders, like Bo Sanchez, sina Alvin Barcelona, sina
Brother Arun,
sa lahat ng mga, kahit sina Jeric, di ba? Si Brother Toh lang yung nagpo-post ng something nerdy. As in, at saka, lagi ako nakaka-release sa mga na pinopost niya. Siyempre, number one fan ako ni Brother Toh ng kanyang mga memes, mga
nakikita
daily.
Nakikita niya po yung sarili niya sa inyo. Kasi ganun din siya.
Exactly. Sabi ko, parang ito, it's like me, but I'm younger. Ay, sorry. joke. By the way po pala, sometimes I will use humor when I'm uncomfortable. So, please bear with me. By the way, okay. Sa mga audience namin, this is the first time that we are talking to Brother Toh, and we thank him so very much ko po kasi for giving the time.
Thank you po.
Kahit kami stranger.
You're welcome.
Napaka niya. So, Brother Toh, can you tell us more something about yourself? Kasi kahit kami, like we said, this is the first time we're actually speaking with you.
Yeah.
Can you give more details?
Or kahit how do you introduce yourself kung kayo po?
Kung manyari, magliligaw kayo.
Mag-introduce kayo sa sarili.
Tapos kami yung mga in-laws nyo, future in-laws.
Mano po.
Bawang ka ng Diyos.
And then, yan. So, hello. Thanks, Tops and Glenn, for inviting me. I love this. Actually, ingit kami kasi kami gusto namin mag-podcast. Di pa namin nagagawa.
Oh.
So, kudos to you for stepping out in boldness.
Yeah.
My name is Toh Relova, like these two, which we found out just today. I'm also a civil engineer.
Wow!
I graduated long time ago, but I am now a builder of the feast I build. I'm a feast builder of the Feast Makati Legaspi. It is one of the Makati feasts. And sa amin nung unang panahon, parang tagal na, last year, nung nakakita pa tayo sa labas, we were in the Greenbelt side or the Legaspi side, kaya Feast Makati Legaspi. I became a builder actually this same month, 4 years ago, so 2017, March 2017 yung official date that I started. But ever since that feast started, I was always behind the scenes. Ako yung lagi kaming wife ko nag-build ng music team from scratch. Since it started 2009, I was the events head, so everything whatever the feast needed, ako yung in charge, marketing, social media, the whole setup, etc. So I really was part of building and helping out the feast behind the scenes before. But prior to that, 30 plus years, I came to the Lord to know Jesus in when I was 12 years old. So 1986 pa ako, una nag-attend ng prayer meeting. Ang prayer meeting ko, sa Makati rin, and incidentally, it's the same side of Makati kung saan ako nagbibuild ngayon, sa Legaspi rin. Where Enterprise Building now is, that was formerly San Miguel Building, nung before they tore it down to create Enterprise. So I was 12 years old. My dad brought me and my family, my siblings there, and I've never stopped since. That was still the same. That's the same community where I am part of now. That's Light of Jesus.
Wow.
So Brother Bo, I've known Brother Bo almost all my life. Siya head namin sa caring group.
So
as young brother.
Sa
so Oo, ninong ko sa kasal. Ninong ko sa kumpil. Wow. Bago ikasal, kailangan i-kumpil. So, kinuha ko rin wow. Ninong sa kumpil. So, I was really... I grew up with Brother Bo, and I still at this till now, 30 plus years after, I still admire the guy, same guy, same character, same humility, same authenticity, si Brother Bo. Yeah, and then I also run a company. The company I run now is based in Makati, and we sell hospital equipment. So nagamit pa rin yung engineering ko. Yeah. So engineering in sales ako doon, mm-hmm. and we bring a German brand here to the Philippines and install it in hospitals.
Wow.
And I love superhero stuff.
Yeah, kaya ako naging fan niyo actually.
Ano po siya parang since childhood or kailan niyo po na ano na parang may interest kayo sa
ano ba yung mga hapa? Ano kayo ba batang 90s din? Lumaki during that time na kung saan maraming kabataan ang naniwala na si Ultimate Warrior ay namatay nung binuhat si Andre the Giant. Yung mga kayo ba ay dun sa
Hulk Hogan days? More Hulk Hogan days. 80s. 80s ako.
Oh, 80s.
More in the late 80s siguro yung pinaka-era namin. Mid-80s to late 80s. Actually, wala pang inakakatawa doon. At those times, Superman lang naman ang superhero nun. Hindi naman wala man ang Thor, wala pang Iron Man. Ang baduy pa actually ng Thor and Iron Man.
Exactly, yung animation
niya. Cool.
Corny, oo. So, yung batang Thundercats DC kayo, di ba? Parang batang
Thundercats. Thundercats. Mga Thundercats, mga Legion, ano? Visionaries?
Exactly, Visionaries. Knights of the Magical something.
So, bali, sino po? Or ano po yung parang naka-influence sa inyo? Or parang dala sa inyo sa ganong parang naging interesting kayo sa mga ganon superheroes or pop cultures parang ganyan.
Yeah. Mostly cartoons sa TV. Mm-hmm. Wala pa naman internet before. So cartoons sa TV like Saturday morning cartoons, di ko alam kung nabutan yun.
Yes, nabutan ko po yun.
Space Ghost.
Space Ghost.
Mga Space Race. Tapos siguro mga Fraggle Rock, mga weeknights, may mga actually simula pa lang may mga superheroes na nagsimula ng bandang late parting, The Flash, 'di ba yung unang The Flash
series,
live
TV
yun,
series.
Grabe.
Yung actor is also the same actor who played Barry's father do sa bagong series.
Yes, John Wesley something.
Yeah, exactly. Tumama, nag-nerd out kami dalawa. Yung misis ko, clueless. Actually, this is what the podcast is all about. I'm the geeky husband and she's the clueless wife. That's why I'm nerding with her. Trying to nerd out with my clueless wife.
Galing. Usually naman galing. Ganun din naman kami.
Ako lang. Okay.
How about you, si Sis Anne? Is she as clueless as her?
Or katulad
niyo? Yeah, medyo din. Well, she likes her own, yan, Wonder Woman, fanatic. Pero hindi naman like us. hindi naman as, iba yung ano niya, iba yung hilig talaga. I think it's more with us, yung mga guys na gano'n din, na talagang mahilig sa gano'n.
Okay, so from there po, so paano po kayo parang nag connive or paano po kayo nag-meet na kung halimbawa is meron kayong gusto na panoorin na something something na superheroes and then paano nyo po siya
nagkaroon ba kayo ng experience na nanonood kayo yung something na talagang gustong-gusto niyo and you want your wife to be there with you pero talagang hindi kayo maka-concentrate kasi kada eksena sino yan
naman hindi ganun si Sis Anne masyado.
Diba, naka-experience ba kayo ng ganun na maya-maya na lang sino yan ano nangyari
maya na lang normal
yun.
Well actually ang kagandahan lang ngayon ng recent era ng superhero movies, ng MCU, DCU, is sobra siyang interesting kahit hindi ka fanatic, di ba? Like yung pumasok si Iron Man before, sobra siyang naging hit na even non-Iron Man fans loved the concept and started entering. Actually, di ba? Thor, di ko type before kasi para siyang Viking.
Oh, exactly.
Isa comics, ah.
based from
hindi siya appealing eh.
Norwegian ano eh.
Pero now because of yun, Chris Hemsworth nakakumuha ko naman naging cool si Thor and she would like it as well actually. MCU movies MCU gusto na ni Anne eh. Tapos kasi mga latest like yung sa Flash sa TV Arrow
yung
naging interesting na for naging interesting na eh. Like yan Supergirl fanatic watcher din siya ng Supergirl
wow. Sa TV buti pa siya kasi hanggang ngayon yung misis ko wala pa rin eh. More on ano talaga eh soap opera yung kina Judy
hindi naman hindi drama. Na ako
si Namimiya yan yung mga
K-drama ba K-drama ba K-drama.
Okay, hindi siya nang actually kahit nga K-drama hindi to
ano. Hindi po. Wala po talaga.
Pero ano, brother to, are you just like me kasi yung mga yan katulad ng mga kinahihiligan natin nung bata even now, ginagamit niyo ba siya as an example or as an analogy when it comes to your preaching? Kasi that's what I'm doing especially when Infinity War came out and when we were talking about sacrifice, I always use Iron Man sacrifice or yung mga choices na ginawa ni Vision. Pero nakikita ko yung iba, parang like her, clueless, hindi sila makarelate. Pero ang point is, I'm just using that as an example. Yeah. Are you also doing the same thing?
Yeah. Actually, depends sa topic. I mean, ayokong pilitin kung hindi naman. Pero there's a time nag-preach ako sa amin nung kananood ko lang ng Thor Ragnarok. Tapos exacto yung ending topic na yung laging sinasabi ni Thor, I love what he said there. Sabi niya, and after he did something heroic, he always says, that's what heroes do.
Oh.
So exacto ng ending ng talk ko, ending ng talk, ano yun, dramatic moment, emotional, everyone's about to worship, excited na, parang, and we do good because that's what Christians do. Parang ganun. So parang, to drive a point, yes. Especially dahil cool ngayon, especially dahil people watch. Eh kami pa naman, when lumabas yung mga Marvel, na una kami, talagang first day, nandun kami, kasi ayaw namin makarinig ng spoilers. yun ang nasa second level of hell, yung spoilers. Manag-spoil, grabe.
Oo nga eh.
Kaya nung araw ng Endgame, talagang nanood kami ng day one, bumili ako ticket early, talagang, even going inside the cinema, naka-headphones ako, baka may marinig ako. Kasi sira na yung panonood mo at paniniwala mo.
Stay away from social media. Kung ganun.
No, ay talaga. Talagang blackout ako until I watch it. Then I'm done. Pero hindi ako nagsuspoil. Iba hindi nagpapaspoiler, pero sila naman nagsuspoil. Mali. I mean, you should really also respect the experience for everyone.
Exactly.
Parang siya po.
Kaya we use topics kung related. And minsan, if I make a special talk, pwede, kasi daming makukuhang stories naman from every inspiration that God gives.
Ako naman, ano, kasi parang kahihayaman. Usually, most of my wisdom nanggagaling sa mga movies at series na kinukuha ko. Hindi kasi ako ganun ka book reader, although hindi appropriate yung background. Hindi ako ganun, DVD hindi ako reader, pero most of the knowledge or wisdom is taken from movies na napapanood ko. Kasi, in a way, parang it's also a depiction of real life eh. Yun yung ginagawa kong inspiration. Pero are you the type of nerd ba na kalimbawa kapag nakapanood kayo kalimbawa ng MCU any Marvel movies, especially yung what just came out sa Disney Plus yung WandaVision, kayo ba yung type ng nerd na
WandaVision?
By the way,
iyakan ka. Tapos ba?
Ay, ito, umiyak din.
Ako kahit hindi po ako galing nun. Parang na-hook na rin ako dun sa pang-last episodes.
Sabi na ako lungkot, no? Parang,
Pwedeng gamitin itong mga quotes, yung mga quotable quotes. Pwedeng gamitin itong what is love, what is grief if not love persevering? Yung mga
ganda nun. Narinig, noong una sinabi yun, nakatanim, yung ganda nun.
I'll use that.
Yun yung mga maganda din eh. Ang galing na writers, actually, these movies. Yes. Hindi lang sa action, hindi lang effects. Pero
exactly.
Yung mga lessons eh, tama ka dun eh. They have a good platform to share good stories like that, like yung self-sacrifice, yung evolution, di ba? Iron Man, mayabang before si Tony, tapos eventually bumait, tapos naging heroic, tapos ultimate sacrifice. Kaya parang, WandaVision, ang galing.
Especially when you have a lot to lose, di ba? That's the time when he chooses to sacrifice himself. But, ayaw ba yung type ng nerd na after yung manood ng mga WandaVision, yung napupunta kayo sa mga tawag dito mga
other sites pa.
I mean,
para
go deeper, ano ba yung mga
to go deeper.
Yung mga new, anong tawag doon yung mga
new rockstar, new rockstar. Ni forum.
New rockstar.
Siya din po.
Yung mga Easter eggs.
Si Eric Boss.
Yeah.
I'm Eric Boss.
Yung parang yung mga ay maganda, ay yung mga pala. Parang ano, lalo na like movies like WandaVision or shows like WandaVision, sobrang kang engrossed na parang mamimiss mo sila kasi you want to research a little more. Parang kasi mamimiss mo sila. Pero I mean, nakakatawa. Yung Wonder Woman wasn't really good, di ba?
Yes.
I don't know. I don't say no. Kanya-kanyang perspective. But 1984, Wonder Woman was kind of okay. I mean, action-wise. Pero maraming nag... I mean, the longer na nagde-deal, nga, hindi maganda yung pagkagawa. Pero one... Pero kasi it was emotional, meant to be emotional, di ba?
Yeah.
Kaya,
yes.
Kaya yun nangyari na naging soap drama, soap opera, sabi ng iba. Pero yung WandaVision, a very good way of doing a superhero movie with emotions, with ano, relatability. Kasi loss di ba?
Exactly. Yes.
Loss. Kaya parang galing.
Oh, di ba?
Kaya nakaka-miss, parang sana, parang may miss mo, ano nangyari sa kids?
Yeah.
Ano
nangyari? Parang you want si more.
Si Mephisto.
Oh, at saka, it's not just about, ano, the capes, the special effects, the fighting, yep. Yung, ano, the people behind it, the human side of the story. Kaya
galing.
Sinasabi nila, ay, ba't ka ba nanonood? Di ba pambata yan? Parang hindi eh. You go deeper to it eh. Diba?
Galing. Yeah. So, kaya parang ano, that's a good way of creating a show na hindi lang flying and effects.
Yes,
it. It's really human behavior, human stories. Kaya relatable. Tayo may lipad pa.
But I'm going to ask something a little controversial. Okay lang ba?
Go bro.
Kala nyo ha, ano, may controversial part din tayo. Hindi, actually naging controversial to sa community. Especially sa mga religious group, and especially when you grow up with a very strict religious family.
Yep.
Meron bang mga instances na kung saan yung may mga off-limits na shows kasi they say that it's not good for you or it's...
Lalo po kayo, you're a leader,
preacher,
builder kayo, peace builder.
Parang, mapanoodin to kasi may ganito.
Do you impose po na ganun?
Pero ikaw, since nakikita mo yung deeper meaning behind of it, dinidisregard mo yung other, ano, meron po ba ganong instances sa inyo na...
Well, may mga shows na totally namang satanic and demonic that I think doon pa lang alam na natin wag na tayo tumuloy.
Yes, yeah.
I mean, yeah. Pero may mga ganun, may mga outright na ganun na they try to disguise it into making it look cool para i-accept ng modern, ano, you know, medyo what we want to help our flock also avoid para hindi rin ma-sway away, parang ganun. Regularly naman, it's more of, before it, we came from an era na sobra namang extreme, sobra strict.
Yes,
na anything that shows magic.
Yes.
Na uiwas, parang ano. Pero now, it's more of, we also know naman that there are stories and there are lessons from stories. As long as it doesn't, like, it wasn't created for that, I think it's not naman a bad thing. As long as you're mature enough to know kung ano yung masamang-masama na talagang nasa kabilang panig at yung hindi.
Kasi I remember Brother Jeric nung bata daw siya. Siyempre, I don't know if inabot niyo yung BTX na anime. Have you heard? Medyo late na.
Hindi ako ma-anime.
Diba? Naalala ko si Brother Jeric. Kasi meron doon isang move, special move yung character, si Tipi Takamiya, which is yung tinatawag na Messiah Feast, o mga batang 90s. So, yung nanay niya, sabi niya, uy, huwag mo sinasabi yan, kasi Messiah, si Jesus yan. So, yung mga ganyang instances, ba, parang sobrang naman extreme, tapos you try to defend it. And, right, one good example, ito ha, sasabihin ko na, like Game of Thrones, I know that it's a medyo controversial. I've seen a lot of articles online that were being posted now. Why Christians should not watch Game of Thrones? Because of this, and this. And I'm going to confess, I was a fan of Game of Thrones because not because of yung may mga nudity or profanity, but I can see the real life depiction of politics, real life depiction of being ano ba yung totoong ibig sabihin ng loyalty. Through definition of honor, yun yung nakikita ko. And then ang sabi ko, when I can skip the nude part, tapos hindi, even if you try to skip and cut that, bawal pa rin. So, meron ba kayong ganung klaseng argument with someone?
Or with or the like, Game of Thrones? Ganun ba,
something
din po
like
ba
that, like Game of Thrones
yun?
Or any other shows, nagkaroon ba kayo ng yeah, time you yeah. try to defend something because you can see yeah. the deeper message from it, but then other people will try to over-demonize that show. Yeah, yeah. Did you have an instance like that?
It's really a shaky ground there. Kasi, well, one thing is we consider it entertainment. Mm-hmm. More of, well, we watch Game of Thrones. Yeah. We love Game of Thrones mm-hmm. as well.
controversy.
Pero, yeah. Pero, we consider it as a story. As a story, a good story that as anything you watch, it causes entertainment. It causes lessons bringing. May konting parts that, yeah, you censor na lang. Pero it was a transition because again, yeah, before the unang panahon nung bago pa lang kami sa community, bago pa lang community, talagang no agad din, no. As in red flag no. Without even knowing more. So parang it's more of we came to a point that we got to know what to judge is good and bad.
Yes.
And if we know it's bad na. Mm-hmm. Then we avoid. Mm-hmm. Then like it's witchcraft or
yes.
witchcraft in that sense, na talaga satanic mm-hmm. witchcraft, sorcery, mga ganun, mm-hmm. or mga ganon na sobrang sinful naman na the other side of kasi this is only the mga ano mga demonic eh, pero may other side of sin
yes.
of mm-hmm. of really bad morals and ganon. Dun medyo parang ano na parang guards up na pero. Also, it's more of a well, of course, also nasa tamang age yan. I mean, younger kids totally wag na kasi developmental sila, whether it be in their values, in their faith. Yan ang wag natin encourage or sana wag natin payagan na manood ng mga ganon. Pero if you're older like us, na you know where you stand, you know your faith. You can see it as a literature, as a story, as a source of entertainment in a way, as a source of parang something like that. Na you watch eh, without necessarily supporting it.
Yes.
Again, there's another side of it. Na sino ba ang nag-create? Is it are they creating things to preach a message
yeah.
na maging acceptable ang ganitong behavior, mm-hmm. ganitong lifestyle. Kasi marami naman shows, ganon. Premarital sex, yes. homosexuality, mm-hmm. etc. Mm-hmm. And they make it look cool. Mm-hmm. And that's the opposite naman. Mm-hmm. And yun, it's a good thing as Christians also to try to steer our flock mm-hmm. to know that mm-hmm. para hindi rin sila sobrang brain wash
yes.
into seeing that that's cool. So, yun. So, it's more of yon, more of guarding yourself, knowing where you stand, knowing that what you're watching isn't something you should believe in terms of what yeah. you're teaching, mm-hmm. but as an entertainment, mm-hmm. and knowing who is creating it. Is are you like supporting a movement against God, or it's just like literally entertaining, and that, mm-hmm. and at the end of the day, you go home, you go back to your faith, and you continue to stand on what you believe in
yes.
mm-hmm. to be true. Na hindi ka masway o sabi kasi na show okay na pala to, so siguro okay na. Yon. So you when you know who you are, where you stand, your beliefs, you're able to hopefully watch mga ganon mm-hmm. if at all mm-hmm. with guards up. Sabi niya, Captain America shield mm-hmm.
up. Yeah, okay. Medyo. Yun nga, tama yung sinabi nyo eh. Sometimes people will be showing something that is bad and they'll try to look cool. My next question is, kasi ngayon, di ba, parang merong yung mga concept ngayon sa mga movies, kahit sa TV series, unlike before, way, way back, parang napaka, ano, yung black and white, a villain is a villain because they're bad.
Yeah, yeah.
And a hero is a hero because they're good. But then right yeah. now, they're showing the more vulnerable side of a hero and also the moral side of a villain. Kaya nga maraming mga lumalabas sa mga shows and movies na ang hero isang anti-hero like this one. Diba? Si Venom. He's an
yep.
anti-hero. Deadpool
yep.
is also yep. an anti-hero. Joker is also yep. an anti-hero. Parang, do you think in a way, sometimes parang medyo worrying yung mga ganong type ng scene na, like you said, they're going to make yep. it look cool to be someone who is always say no, ay hindi pwede. Kasi meron akong stand, I have to fight for my right. Do you think it's cool or mm-hmm. do you think it's a little bit worrying with this narrative is going going to right now or
yep.
ano, okay lang ba 'yon kumbaga?
Yeah. Actually on the flip side, it makes you understand bad people that may good din naman sila. I mean, I see the point.
Everyone is born evil, di ba? Parang ganun.
Oo, okay. kasi panahon na, well, panahon ko, bad is bad, good is good. Pag bad ka, masama ka, we wish, like Steven Seagal movies.
Oh, exactly.
Ang galing ng pagkagawa ng Steven Seagal movies na sobrang bad ng bad guys, na pag binubog na sila ni Steven Seagal, tuwan-tuwa tayo.
Exacto.
The more violent you are, he is to them. Break your bones. Go!
Go!
Kasi bad is bad. Oh. Ngayon, I agree. Nag-turn into that mode ang storytelling na you see the other side of the bad people na may conflict
like
din pala
Thanos,
sila.
Kasi kala na, good example is Thanos.
Galing, oh. Thanos, galing. Kasi may story pala siya. I mean, may... If you come to think of it, some people may point.
Oh, diba?
Kasi if overpopulated ang mundo, mamamatay ang lahat kaysa sa sacrifice of some na may point. I mean, di ba? Kaya one thing is, pwedeng ang masamang effect is di okay pala sila. In the sense na we can also be glorifying bad. But in the flip side, which I feel naman is, you get to understand people na there's still good in bad people. Na there's still hope for bad people. Yung talk natin lately sa talk kay Weeds and Wheat sa OG Tales. It's more of that. We lament the bad people outside and we wish kunin na sila ni Lord. Pero sana wag eh.
Diba kasi kung kinuha sila ni Lord. Sige, sampalin mo. Banotin mo siya.
Kasi kung kinuha sila ni Lord, baka tayo kasama kasi there's also bad in us.
Yeah,
so parang it makes you realize, may pinagdadaanan sila. Some people hindi halata kasi parang ang sama nila. Pero meron din silang conflict. Now, you should not glorify and exalt the bad naman, but you should also realize na meron din silang sariling journey. So yung ganun. Like, for example, classic example, Karate Kid.
Yun, exactly. Si Cobra Kai, di ba?
Cobra Kai. Cobra Kai nga pala ang tawag na doon. Sobrang bad guy si LaRusso eh. Now you see, in his mind, bad guy si Daniel.
Johnny. I forgot his last name also.
Johnny Storm.
Fantastic po yun eh.
So Johnny. Kala mo, bad guy siya, tas good guy to. Pero in his mind, flip, si LaRusso yung nag-agaw ng girlfriend na nananahimik lang sila.
Oh, ang bully parang, si LaRusso, diba? No?
Kaya there was a point in the show, kumakampi tayo kay Johnny, nanakawat sa kanya. Mm. Tapos parang, nung nagbubully siya, doon ako natatawa nga, bully pa rin talaga siya.
Oh.
Pero yun, it's a classic example na may bawat tao may conflict, may pinagdadaanan. And so as Christians, our goal now is to help those who feel that they're the baddest know that indeed they're still good in you and that you are still redeemable and that people can bring the Lord can bring you back into his fold so that you can resolve that. So yeah, I think that's what is the good thing about that. It teaches us that there's still another side in every person.
Exactly.
There's another good side.
The bad can still be healed by the good.
Tsaka yung sinasabi ni, di ba, Brother Bo, hurt people. That's why some people are hurting someone because of the hurt that they've gone through in their life.
That's true.
So nakaka-relate ka ba? Si LaRusso? Yeah. Nag-gets mo ba si LaRusso?
Okay na yun.
Si Beno.
Ano nga ba na yun ang guy?
Johnny, ano?
Zan?
Okay na yun.
Yan, nakalimutan na. Parehas po tayo ng mga ganyang moments. May mental block talaga ako sa mga ganyan.
So dami na information.
Sobrang daming ano ba yung huling movie or series na when we went through, para sa mga audience namin, Brother Toh and Sister Anne went through as in sobrang kumbaga sa superhero, kumbaga si Thor, yun nga kasi sunod-sunod yung mga tragedy si Thor, di ba? He lost his mom, his brother.
Si WandaVision.
Or si WandaVision and Brother Toh also went through a lot in his life. Yep. So I recommend for you to watch yung Feast But actually, it was last year. Doon ko yung una napakinggan yung inyong testimony. And also doon sa Salanga Speaks podcast.
Yes, yan, yeah.
Na tatlong beses iniyakan ni Mrs.
Yan, so, your testimonial about yung kanilang story.
Oh, yung kanilang story. Ano yung, meron bang mga shows or movies na, siyempre, ang pinagkukuhanan nyo ng lakas is God, community. Pero meron bang certain or a specific show that also gave you an inspiration on that dark part of your life? O wala? Pinipilit ko lang kasi nerding with you yung pangalan na
ito. Napakisip tuloy ako. Meron ba?
Ano bang year nangyari? Kasi sunod-sunod siya. Parang every other year yata yun.
Siguro yun. Actually, kapatid ko, Thor. Now that you put it, pwede rin. Kasi maraming ang pinagdaanan, but yung scene na yun, nung nasa Endgame, na kinuha niya yung hammer, na, well, sakto, katawang ko Thor na. yung kabilang Thor na. So, goal ko, pag lumabas yung bagong Thor, kailangan Thor-like na rin ako. Diba, yung nakuha niya yung hammer, I'm still worthy. Yung sabi rin niya, na despite the many things that happened to him, despite his own, ano, parang his own fault, na nagpabaya na siya sa buhay niya, he was grieving, etc. He's still worthy. So parang it's a good lesson sa akin din na my problems do not make who I am. It's God's identity for me who makes me who I am. So I'm still worthy despite the tragedies that happened to my life. Incidentally, hindi ko nga gusto si Thor, pero naging brand ko yun. Ako na si Thor.
Yeah.
Alam niyo
yun? Almighty Thor.
Yeah.
Because of my name, T-O-H-R.
Hindi dahil ka mukha niyo.
Yun din. Actually, pinipilit niya eh. Kaya nung tumaba siya, ako yung model niya. Di ba napagupit siya dati? Long hair. Hindi naman ako long hair. And napagupit siya, hindi kinaya talaga.
So siya pala yung nag-i-imitate sa inyo. How dare he?
Grabe. How dare he? Wala man ang royalty.
Wala man yung...
For the effort. Yeah, so parang so in a way actually naging brand ko rin siya.
Yes.
Ayan, tama.
Kala ko nga yun yung shirt niya ngayon. Ayan, oh, may
nagbigay ng maliit na Thor dito. Ay, podcast niya pala niya. So yun, so parang naging brand ko talaga siya because it's a good brand din, mighty. Yeah. So everything that I try to do is to be mighty, to be that.
Mm-hmm. I like what you said despite everything that Thor went through, kung ano din yung ginawa niya sa katawan niya after yung depression niya, he was so happy that he was still worthy. Kasi at the same time, God, yun nga, maganda yung sinabi niya. Kasi naalala ko yung sinabi ni brother, or a brother, kasi for someone to be worthy, you have to be as pure as Captain America, di ba? That's why he was able to lift hammer. Pero nung na-realize ko, hindi pala, dapat maging kasing pure ka. I think it's being worthy when it counts. When you, kasi kita mo naman yung nangyari kay Thor, di ba? Naging pabaya siya, hindi lang sa katawan niya, kundi sa kanyang mga sinasakupan. Pero nagulat siya, I'm still worthy. Kasi nga, when it really calls for you to be worthy, and you become worthy, I think that's the whole point of why he was still able to lift Mjolnir. Kaya niyo ba i-pronounce yun?
Yung pangalan? Mjolnir.
Oo, oh, di ba?
Hammer na lang.
Thor's hammer na lang. So, ano ba yung tinatanong ko? Naging ano po ba kayo? Ng mga K-drama? How about K-drama? What do you think about?
K-drama, hindi. Si Mrs. Pero hindi rin lagi. Kasi busy rin siya. Pero,
sige po.
Mga Chloe.
Mga Chloe.
Mga...
Meteor Garden, yung sumikat sina, ang F4.
Hindi rin. Si Anne, hindi.
I'm you!
So, parang, usually nga yata mga ganun yung mga wife na mga preachers ang more on sa K-drama.
Puro lang ka naman kinibigan ng K-drama, di ba?
Hindi ako. Yung iba, yung mga wife na mga preachers usually sa Philippines, di ba? Opo.
Hirap nga lang, sabi lang niya hirap manood kasi kailangan binabasa yung magaling yung reading skills dahil subtitle.
Pero anime kasi 80s kid kasi
anime hindi. Di ako mabot.
90s is
He-Man yun.
He-Man, Thundercats, Silverhawks,
Visionaries,
di ba?
Gobots,
yun, Transformers, the original one.
Okay.
So, dadako naman tayo sa isang napaka-interesting na segment. I don't know if you saw our episode with Brother Jerick and Sis April. Sis Apple.
Oy, yung usually kay Boy Abunda.
Ah, kilala niyo naman si Boy Abunda. Okay. Ayoko si Boy Abunda.
Before.
Can you connect us with him so that we can interview him?
So, di ko ba meron siyang yung mga
yung fast talk.
Fast talk niya.
Game.
So, magpapastok tayo. So, dapat maging honest kayo, unang-una.
Okay.
Preacher kayo. So, dapat walang sugar coating. Ay, pero, no need to worry. Hindi ko naman po kayo tatanungin ng sex or chocolate. I reserve that question for Brother Bo.
Anyway.
So, ito naman, ipang ano lang. Pang nerding. So, answer as fast as you can. Pag meron akong gustong for you need to elaborate more, we'll pause.
Okay, if you want to explain
if
why.
If you want to explain
okay
why.
Sure, yeah,
okay.
So, are you ready? First question. Mirror Thor's original hammer or Stormbreaker?
Mjolnir, syempre. Kasi yun ang kilala siya. Mm. Saka meron ako na.
Even though Stormbreaker is most powerful and can summon the Bifrost.
Kahit may power siya of Bifrost. Bifrost. Ano yun? Yung kay Heimdall.
Ano ba tawag doon? Bifrost po. The Bifrost.
Kahit yun Thorpe, flying and original hammer.
Sa original
tayo. Brand niya ni Thor hammer.
Jane Foster or Valkyrie?
Lady Love, Jane Foster. The new Thor.
Yeah, of course. Oh, spoiler alert. Describe in three words your thoughts about Victor Magtanggol.
I don't watch.
Okay. Pero alam, you're aware there was a Victor Magtanggol. Okay, tama. Baka tayo ma-ban ng GMA7. Okay. Choose one. Chris Hemsworth as Thor, Chris Pratt as Captain as Star-Lord, Chris Evans as Captain America, or Jeff Goldblum as Game Master.
Taika Waititi as Korg. Sige. Siyempre, Chris Hemsworth as Thor. The Thor. Lalo na ngayon, lumaki pa muscle niya.
Oo nga eh.
Yung sa bagong sets, kaya napapressure tayo.
Kaya niyo ba yun? Magtulak ng malaking gulong ng truck?
Grabe.
Diba?
He is Thor. Godlike.
Kunti na lang, mga 50 years pa. Kaya natin yan. Who is your Loki? Sino ang Loki sa buhay?
In real life?
Ako.
Sino yung Loki, yung someone who betrayed you many times but still was able to forgive, and right now you're already good kasi by the end of Loki's life, diba okay naman sila magkapatid, diba?
Yeah.
So who is your Loki?
Pwedeng i-alias
nyo, baka kasi masira ang reputation.
Loki ba ako? Parang wala naman.
Wala naman. No one has betrayed
wala
you.
Naman.
Yung mga ex nyo, hindi alaban.
Wala akong ex eh.
Ah, wow.
First and only.
Yan ang sabi nyo sa kanya.
Sa public.
Okay.
Ay, meron Loki, si Rex Rubillos.
Lahat talagang pinangalanan nyo.
Hindi, kaasara ko lagi si Builder of Peace Lancaster, si Brother Rex Rubillos.
Inano kayo? Paano kayo pinagtaksila ni Rex Rubillos?
Lagi lang kami nag-aasara nun.
Kaasara niya kami.
He's a good friend.
So, yun na yun.
Yun ang pinaka-inaalaska ko lang nowadays.
Inaasara niya.
Lagi tumatabi sa akin pag Builders Meeting. Malayo naman ako.
Wow, bully din pala si Brother.
Sana mapanood mo to, Brother Rex.
Okay, for you, what makes a person worthy to lift Thor's hammer?
Or kayo po. Or sa inyo.
If you're going to be Odin, and you will be able to put yung spell doon sa kay what will make a person worthy to lift Thor's hammer?
Siguro belief in who he really is. Kasi lahat naman tayo worthy. Yan ang tinuturo natin sa Feast. We're all in God's image. We're all Imago Dei. We're all capable. But some of us don't think we are. Some of us, by the sin that affects us or by the sin that we give into because we don't think we're worthy, we become even more feeling unworthy. But we all are already worthy if we would only care to lift. Siguro analogy-wise, we don't lift the hammer because we think we can't. But if we would try pala, we can because we already are worthy.
Wow. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Talk material na yun.
galing,
so ako po, may isang question is, meron, yep, meron po ba kayong experience or circumstances in life wherein you're become a hero in your way, naging hero kayo?
Meron ba kayong inligtas sa lumaragasang baha?
Yeah. Merong ano, like there was one time, nakalimutan ko, sino ka ba yan? May nagsabi sa akin na I saved him from drowning, a kid, na I think, may nagsaswimming kami, sino ka ba yan? Someone na ka-swimming ko before, na good swimmer kasi ako. Pero at that pool, there was a time na nagda-drown siya, tapos inangat ko lang siya. Tapos later on, sinabi niya, you know, I don't know kung pamangkin ko ba, I was drowning na pala din.
Oh.
Na hindi ko na realize. And later on, I found out that he was grateful siya. We don't keep track naman. We just, diba, in purpose. Just do good. Don't do it for the reward. Isa rin, there's one guy that, nung umakit siya sa gate, tapos diba, sorry, medyo graphic.
Okay lang po.
May mga spikes. Tapos biglang gumawa ng chup-chup. Sa ano niya, as in nakita yung may mga nag-spill out. Tapos rinash ko siya sa hospital tinulungan ko siya. Mm-hmm. Ayun, rinash ko siya sa hospital. Mm-hmm. So, saved his life, he's okay na.
Wow, talagang hero pala, no? No. Talagang Thor. Thor na Thor.
With that po,
because that's what heroes do.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what heroes do.
With that po, mag-exit muna po.
Nandiyan na yung delivery.
Thank
you
po. Just try to, are you worthy right now? If not, how can you be worthy? If this is a message not only for you but for everyone, Alan.
Mm-hmm. I think we are all worthy. And so I can say I am worthy, not because of me, but because of God and my identity in Him. I mean, the problem of a lot of people naman now is sobrang, lalo na pag Pinoy, parang, hindi ako worthy.
Humble.
You don't want, over-humble na. I mean, humble is good, but over-humble naman, yung tipong, pag binati mo, hindi naman. Fake yan, or mga ganun. I think we should always stand in confidence then, in good confidence, hindi naman yung overboard confidence na proud naman, pride na. Pero we should all know that we are worthy, we are all loved and capable of happiness, of life, of joy. And that makes us worthy, not because of us, but because of God as a gift to us. He made us worthy. So, yeah.
Amen. Wow, ang galing ah. Ang galing. Oh, 'di ba mga ka-nerding, akala nyo puro mga cartoons lang tayo dito. That's one good reason why I continue to watch movies and series, because marami kang yun nga, kay Thor na lang, 'di ba? And with that, thank you very much, Brother Toh. I really wish that we could go on kasi ano eh, katulad ng mga sinabi niyo, mga 80s, kasi I also grew up in the 80s eh. Ang dami ko napanood na Saturday morning cartoons, but you know, yep. I wish that we could have you back dito, yep, if you have the time. By the way, if you have anything to plug, I think that right's the time to plug something like the Feast Makati. Kailan, I believe that you're streaming sa Facebook, di ba? Yeah, you can invite everyone.
Yeah. Actually, this week, we celebrate our first year in lockdown. Kami ang unang feast na nag-broadcast sa lockdown. Kasi nangyari yung lockdown, in-announce si Duterte yung lockdown sa March 12. March 12 was a Thursday, feast namin Thursdays. So that whole week nagde-deliberate kami, magpa-feast pa tayo, baka may lockdown. Yung feast ng Tuesday, tumuloy sila. No Wednesday, nag-decide kami na huwag na natin tuloy, mag-online tayo.
Yeah.
So March 12, nag-gather dito yung team ko sa amin, sa bahay namin. Tapos sobrang ano pa, crude yung paraan namin, yung live stream, compared to how it is
doing
now.
Oh, yeah.
So March 12, 2020, first feast namin, and we have never stopped broadcasting every Thursday since. So every Thursday, if you're free, you can watch it in our Facebook pages, our YouTube channels, Feast Makati Legaspi, or Toh Relova. I have a Facebook page and Instagram page and YouTube page, lahat Toh Relova. So very easy to find me. Anything Toh Relova is me. And may live, dun din nagla-livestream every 7:30 p.m. Thursdays, Manila time.
Yan. Yeah. How about your podcast? I believe that you are already you can make everyone excited. Mag-teaser kayo, Tito. Teaser.
Oh, grabe si Jeric at si J. Paul mang-inganyo eh. Oh. Hindi ko pa nagagawa eh. Nasa checklist ko pa yun, hindi ko pa na-check eh. Pero we might come up with a couple's podcast, kaming dalawang kasawa, para hindi lang ako. Let's see. Sana, I mean, soon.
Very soon.
Yeah. Secret muna kung anong content. Basta maganda.
Yan. Wow. Thank you so much, Brother Toh.
My pleasure, Tops.
This has been a very great episode for us. Sorry for all the technical difficulties. Sa mga ka-learning natin, thank you so much for watching. Continue on to support our podcast. You can get this podcast in Apple Music, Amazon, Spotify, and also we're available on YouTube. So just click the subscribe button. Also ring the bell for notification. Kung meron po kayong mga comments, no bashing, okay? Please. Kita mo naman yung aming usapan ngayon. Napaka banal. So please. So thank you so much, everybody. Thank you very much, Brother Toh. And see you next time sa Nerding With You. Peace, everyone.
God bless, everybody.